Hare Krishna. We can't deprive others of the right to be wrong. Sometimes when we see somebody going on a wrong track, we may not want them to get into unnecessary trouble, and we may warn them, don't go there. But sometimes when we give such advice to people, they may just turn against us and accuse us of being autocrats, accuse us of restricting their freedom, of depriving them of their freedom, and that may sour our relationship with them. Sometimes people have to learn their lessons by experience. It is best if they can learn with their intelligence without going through unpalatable experiences. But sometimes we just need to go through experiences to learn. So if we impose too much force on them, they may do the right thing, but they will resent it. And as soon as our force on them goes off, they will do the wrong thing. So especially say, for example, in parenting, if parents force their children to do the right thing, as soon as they can get the freedom, they may rebel and start doing wrong things wholesale, not because they like those wrong things, but just because they want to get back at their parents. So we can't deprive people of their right to be wrong. This is illustrated even in the Bhagavad Gita itself, where at the end Krishna acknowledges Arjuna's free will. In 18.63, he says, he says, deliberate deeply and then do as you desire. So this means even Krishna is not taking away Arjuna's free will. The very existence of free will means that we can choose to do something wrong. Krishna doesn't deny us of that. But we can facilitate others right to be right. That means we can help others to make the right choice. That's why what does Krishna do? Krishna tells the whole Bhagavad Gita, acknowledges Arjuna's right to choose, which includes the right to be wrong, but then again he reinforces his message. At 18.63 he could have concluded, but from 18.64 to 72, the next 9 verses, he opens his heart, reveals his love for Arjuna and encourages him, beseeches him practically to reciprocate with his call for love. And thus, when Arjuna's turn is to respond, Arjuna responds by agreeing to do Krishna's will. Karishye vachanam tava, he tells in 18.73. So similarly, we can follow in Krishna's footsteps and recognize that when we are guiding someone, if we force them to do something, if we deprive them of their right to be wrong, and they will resent us, and that resentment will be a wrong attitude on their part, which will alienate us from them. If they do something wrong, but we still maintain a cordial relationship with them, we acknowledge their free will, then because the relationship remains cordial, they will come back on the right track and they will come back on course. So for us, we can't deprive others of their right to be wrong, but we can facilitate their right to be right by having the right disposition, by having the right presentation, by acknowledging their freedom, but at the same time giving them the wisdom to use that freedom wisely. Thank you. Hare Krishna.